In this session, we're going to talk about adding a photo gallery. So my art class, I actually want to build out a photo gallery of some of my students' artwork. So the first thing I need to do is create the photo gallery. So I come to the left side, there's photo gallery, and there's an add photo gallery. And then I can name it. So I'm going to say, first grade art. And going to tab out, and it says, yep, that name's okay, so I'm going to go ahead and do next. And you can shrink this up, but this, if you wanted to share this with anybody or give someone else permissions, you definitely could, but I'm just going to click on this arrow to make that go away. Now I can do my add photo. And basically, you just select your image, so I'm going to start picking my photos, and it uploads them. That was a really big photo. That's okay. The alt text, you could add that if you wanted to describe the photo, which might be useful for someone that is blind, if they'd like to kind of get a feel for the type of artwork your first graders did. You can also put a name and description with your photo. This could be like you could do the student's first name and then a description, you know, like maybe they won first prize or something, you know, whatever it is, you can add that type of information in. I'm not going to do that, so I'm just going to kind of leave this all empty. So I go ahead and save that, and now I have my first photo in, and then I can just add another one. Unfortunately, we don't have a bulk file upload, so you can just pick all of them and upload them. We do hope to add something like that in, hopefully this year, but and the reason why we don't is that you really should be thinking about alt text for these and whatever makes sense. So I'm going to get a couple more in here. That one was a little bit smaller, so it didn't take quite so long. And so you can see you can have different size images if you'd like to. Okay. So that should be good. I'm going to save that. I've now created a photo gallery, first grade art. And now I need to add that to my art class page. So I'm going to go back to my pages, and I'm going to edit the art class page. And just like with calendars, I need to change the block. And then I can say I want to put a photo gallery. And the two types are thumbnail and slideshow. The rotator won't make a lot of sense for a website page. So the thumbnail, I'm going to show you that first. Basically, you can kind of just see what happens if you leave settings alone, just do save. Well, it would help to actually pick the photo gallery that I want to show. So I'm going to, it's showing images per row 4. And so you can see that you can do that. If I wanted to change that up a little bit, I could come back in and edit. You could say, let's show 2 per row. And then you can see they're a little bit bigger. But that's how the thumbnail will display. If I wanted to do the slideshow, I'll show you that. This has a height associated with it. There's an autoplay, yes or no, the speed. So if you want to go faster or slower, you can change that. The gallery controls also gives you, the captions. Like if you did put a title and description in, you can always show it or you can do the toggle. Okay, I'm going to do a toggle. So I'm going to save that. And there we are. So if I actually had information, it would actually show on top of the photo, which I might not like. So I might want to make that a little bit taller. So I'm going to make that 700. Okay. And then now the information is actually going to show above the photo. And that's basically it. So if I do a preview, we can see that. It does show the thumbnail, so I can skip around. That's basically it. And then I can publish my changes. Okay, I think that's it. Thanks for watching.